Hi guys, this is Shyam again. So today we are going to see a new topic. It's called a slip gauge. Okay, I think you must have heard about this or seen somewhere in your textbooks or in your mechanical engineering notes. So you must have learned, I think, about this one also. So what you're seeing is in front of me is a slip gauge box. Okay, so slip gauges are normally used to check a gap between the component. It's normally used for calibration of gauges. Normally plug snap gauges will be there. So types of gauges which are used for checking the components, machining components or metal components. So for that one, and mostly metal parts. So where you can you have to check the exact dimension of that gap, then you use a slip gauge. Okay, so what you see in front of me is the total slip box. Okay, so this is actually basically the width of each component. Actually, if you're checking for like 75 mm component, so you have to confirm it with this one, then you can use this one. Okay, so I'm just for an example taking this one to show you the front, back side and everything. Okay, so this is actually made of meter to you. It's written 75 mm, right? Okay, so nothing, just it's a perfect 75. Okay, the 75 mm is the this length. Okay, this total length is the 75 mm. Okay, so I'll just keep it here. So the whole length, from if you are measuring from a scale or a vernier, then you just from here it will be 0 and from here it will be 75 mm. If you check it like this, it will be 75 mm. Okay, similarly this is 100. So I'll just show you the starting readings, from where it starts and how the next one it goes. I'll just show you how. Okay, so starts from 1.0005, 001, 002, 003. Basically it's 4 micron, 5 micron, 6 micron and goes till 009.1, and it goes till 10 microns, 20 micron, 30 micron, 1.03, 04, 05. So each 06 is like 60 micron. Okay, 07, 08 and okay, 1.13. okay, the next division, let me see, let me show you. It's 1.14, 15, 16, 17. It goes like 120, 1.20, 1.23. okay, so you can see the range how it varies. Okay, I'm just showing you because you must know how it really, what kind of ranges are there. So this is normally basic type of the slip gauge box. Okay, 1.42, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48 and 1, and after that 1.50 is not there. Okay, it's given separately. It's 1.5 here, it's given separately. So between that 0.5 and 1 mm is given. So here it's 2 mm, 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, okay, 4.5 and 5.5 and 6, 6.5, 7, 9, 10. So it goes on like that. But the thing you can see here is after 0, okay, after 0.5 hits here, the 0. This is actually 0.5. okay, so this is 0.5, this is 1, okay, 1.5. So after 1 it goes like 1.5, 0.5 increase. Okay, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5. So this is how it goes. And after even 10 also, 10, 12, 13, 13.5, 14 and 20. Okay, so even till what, till you can see till 24.5, till 24.5 it goes on like 0.5, 0.5 increase. Okay, and after that it's 25, it's 50, it's 75 and it's 100. Okay, so let me tell you, if I want to check a gap, so you have a doubt, right? It's 1.43 here, but it's not like here, it's not 53. It's, if I want to check a gap, it's with it like it's 7.53. okay, so 7.53 means what I'll do, I'll just take the 6 mm. Okay, and okay, let me show you a bigger example. Okay, so suppose, okay, I have a block with me here. So the gap of this block, as you can see, it's I've just set it actually. It's 34 mm actually. I just put this one aside. Okay. So this I've set this block. It's 34 mm. Okay. So I have to check 34, but 34 is not there here, because you can see it's 24.5, after that it's 25, so I have take 34. Okay, so for that 34, what I'll do, I'll just take 20, okay, 20 here and a 14 here. Okay, so I'll just take this both. It's pretty tight. Okay, I'm sorry, I think I took the other one. 20 here and 14 here. Okay, so basically this one is the upper one which is there, so it's written below. So I'll just put it here. So I have to actually join this one both. So combined it becomes 34, but I'm just showing you lightly, but you have to really press this one. So you have to like grind on top of this one. You have to keep this downside and you have to grind on top of this. So really there's no air between those two. Okay, so it's 20 mm and 14 mm. So what I'm going to do is 34 mm is the gap between this one. I'm just going to put here. Okay, so this one goes perfectly. That means it's 34 mm. Okay, 20 is there and 14 mm is there. So another thing, while you're checking this one, it should be like both surface, there should not be any ply between this, there should not be any shake between them, it should be like slide between the surface, it should be like zero contact, zero, I mean the contact should be, nothing should be there, nothing should be in between, like zero mm gap. It should not be too tight, but normal, it will be like sliding. Okay, a little bit tighter than this one. So that's the exact spec of this one. So this one is 34, so how I'm measuring is as a 14 and there's a 20, combined you get 34. Okay, so I'm just going to put it here. Okay, okay. So this is how normally we check. If it's a 20 mm then you can use it directly, but it was a combined one, it was 34 mm, so I used a combined set. So it's 20 here and 14 here. So I've combined these two and I've made a block and I've checked it here. So similarly, if I'm checking like it's a, suppose there a 9.5 is there. Okay, you can see a 9.5 here. So 9.5 is there, but I want to check a gap which is 9.53. okay, but a 9.53 is not there. So what I'll do, I just go back to 8. Okay, so this is 8. Okay, so I'll just take this 8 and what I'll do, I have to add it 1.53. okay, what I told, 9.53, right? So I just have to add a 1.53 to this one. So let me check, 1.53 is there, but 1.53 is not there. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll just this is 1.5 is there. Okay, so I have to add a 0.3. okay, 1.53, so 0.03 I have to add, but I can't add this one because there is no there's nothing like 0.03 is there. So here it's 1.03 is there. Okay, but 1.03, I'll just take this one. Okay, this is 1.03, so 8 mm and 1.03. so combined what it happens means 9.03, right? 8 mm and 1.03 is 9.03. so I have to get 9.53. so what I'll do, I just have to find a 0.5. so here it's a 0.5, I'm going to take it and I'm just going to combine all the three, this one. So what I get is 0.5 is here, 1.03 is here, and 8 mm is there. So 8 plus 1.03 is 9.03 and plus 0.5 is 9.53. okay, so this you can check it whatever you want, but you have to really press it really hard and after that only you have to check. Okay, so let's just keep this one in the proper places. Okay, there it goes.
because it's really small, okay, you can just, sometime it goes missing and sometime you have to really find it, but really difficult to find this one. You can only get the whole box and you can't get separated. Okay guys, I think you've learned something about this one, about something, this slip gauge. So I hope you found it really useful, and I've just put some really interesting contents like this in my channel. So if you really like this video, just click on a like button, and if you want to have any queries, if you have any doubts, just put it in the comment box, and do subscribe on the way if possible, so you can just get the notification for my next video. Okay, I'll be just putting up like this interesting contents every day, every week, and something, you know, when time is really there. So there'll be like 10 or 15 videos in the end of the month, so you'll be learning something every day. So that's it guys, I hope you really like this video. So this is Shyam signing off.